Discussion possible motion interviews for District 3 County Board Supervisor. Who are we going to start with first?
Well, I think what we did last time.
Is it just went back and forth?
We went back and forth and alternated who started. So we could bring them both up here, and then this one starts first, this one second, then this one starts first, and this one second. So it gives them a chance to.
Which one's not here?
Colin. You guys want to come here? Or you want to sit up where you are? First, introduce yourselves to, well, we can introduce ourselves first.
Yep.
Lois Hood. Really, I'm going to call you back on that. Board member.
John Gale, County Board.
Terry Weber, County Board.
Phil Anderson, County Board.
Bill Shire.
County Mayor, County Clerk. You guys have to introduce yourselves, we just got who's listening.
I'm Cindy LaPorte, I'm with Martin LaPorte, the county. And do you want anything else, Colin, or just introduce our names?
Names are fine, because we'll start asking questions.
Yeah. My name's Kathy Halber, and I also live in the town of Truth. I live on Allen, just over the line, that's where I'm from.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Kathy, we'll start with you with this first question, okay?
Okay.
Why are you interested in becoming a Rusk County Board member?
So I do quite a bit with the county already. We moved to Rusk County in 2017, when we became county masters. And at the time, my primary responsibility was caregiving for my dad. So I worked part-time and volunteered a lot in the county, so I do a lot of serving with ADRC. Because I was trying to get a crash course and everything I could find out for senior services to help my dad. So, and still volunteer quite a bit with ADRC. Do a lot of workshops, study, all that. Been on the advisory board, and I'm on the governing board as well for ADRC, for Rusk, and Barron counties. And also started with the LAPC right away, so my career was in the environmental field. And so I did school response, so I started on the LAPC volunteering a lot because my schedule, I've been interested in being on the board as I've been in Rusk County and being more involved, but with my caregiving responsibilities, I couldn't really commit to the schedule for the Board of Supervisors. So unfortunately, my caregiving responsibilities aren't anymore. So now I have more control over my schedule and can make bigger commitments and know that I can be around to fulfill those commitments. So since my dad and sister passed, I've taken on more of a role with the farmer's market. I run the farmer's market and just really believe in community service. I spent most of my career in government, every level of government. So I feel like I have a lot of experience in what the role of the county is and how the county can work with the city on partnerships to leverage monies from the state and even the federal government
had experience with some of the committees, and I used to be a 4-H agent here, so I know some of the workings in the county. And I was also on the library board and had a lot of input with that. And I've done a lot with the 4-H program over the years as a volunteer and as the 4-H agent. And I just think that women need more of a voice in county government than what's been on the board before, and because there hasn't been much input from women, and I think we deserve to have a voice.
This question will start with you. What relevant experience do you have that you feel would qualify you to be a Rusk County board member?
Well, the fact that I was on here once before. And one time when I was 4-H agent, I did teach the county board a little bit about Robert's Rules. I don't know if you remember that show. and just knowing how the county government kind of works. And at one time, my father used to be on the county board, so I would get input from him when I had some pressing problems or whatever, and say, okay, how do we work on this? And I think just having an open mind, willing to listen, work, look at all sides of the matter.
Kathy, same question for you.
That was a good answer. Thanks. No, definitely have an open mind. I've been on a lot of boards and committees as well. Like I mentioned, the LAPC, the ERC Advisory Committee, the Governing Board, the Farmers Market Board. In my career, I was on a lot of boards. So I'm familiar with the process, and like the two in every board that I'm currently on, I've been elected to leadership position by my peers, so that speaks to the fact that I take it very seriously and educate myself on the matters and try to be inclusive and come up with a solution that fits for everybody. So I don't honestly think you guys can go wrong, so
either one of us.
Yeah. I can be impressed. So I was in the environmental field. The last job I did before I retired was with the Environmental Protection Agency. I did emergency response. So big trains around us, like I was at Deepwater Horizon down in Alabama. So my duty station was Green Bay. And I did emergency response for all of Wisconsin and UP, so like chemical fires, train derailments, big oil spills, companies go out of business, leave all their hazardous waste behind, things like that. So I coordinated the cleanups on the federal level, but then also did, like, I was in Flint for the water debacle for many months, so I was deployed around the country. And so. And my husband was a captain in the Milwaukee Fire Department. So when we became empty nesters, we decided to leave our dangerous job and move to the Northwoods and have a little homestead. His family has a cabin here on Santa Fe Road. He used to come on here ever since he was a little with the dream of moving here. And I wanted, like I said, to quit and take care of my dad. And be able to spend as much time with him as possible. So, but I worked, since I was born and raised in Ohio, and then went to school in Arizona. So, worked for the Cincinnati Health Department, State of Arizona. Worked in the private sector as well. I was a corporate environmental manager for a farm reconditioning company, where I learned how to do everything wrong. And do everything wrong, and so that's what my career was.
How do you view the role of a board member?
So I believe board members are there to represent your neighbors,
didn't come up with it, I would ask the question even though I knew the answer.
Okay, some of these are kind of redundant, but we'll ask anyway. What skills, expertise, and perspective would you bring to the Rusk County Board?
The skills that I have is being on various committees and boards. I've been on the library board, the trails end board. I used to teach, I was a teacher and 4-H agent, and so I know from various committees that you're on when you're in those positions on how to do things and get along with people, listening to people.
What skills, expertise, and perspective would you bring to the Rusk County Board? There's a lot there. It's like, you guys, it's the movie, it's like, oh man.
I organize, I believe in community service, I believe in Rusk County, I have a good relationship with a lot of the people that, many people that work in the county. I already work well with many in health and human services, ADRC, Land and Water Conservation, Char. And willing to do anything I ask somebody else to do. You know, I don't just talk the talk, I walk the walk. I do tires with Jeremy at Clean Sweep. I sell tickets at the fair for the split the pod. So I feel like by doing those things, you know, as well as, you know, being on the board, you know, gives you the perspective to help make better.
Do you have any issues with committing the sufficient time required to fulfill the board duties? Well, I'm just reading what's going
on. Well, I feel like that's why I haven't done this before, because I didn't have the availability to do it. But now I although I know you guys are in a lot of meetings, that I can meet the schedule commitments. So, yes. I guess, in summary, yes.
You shouldn't have any problems.
Okay. All right. That's pretty easy. That's all the questions we have. Anything you guys would like to add? Anything else you'd like to add? Okay.
So, what else would
we? I think we, yes, that's what we did last time. Step out and then hang out.
Hang
on,
yeah, okay.
Please.
We can find fancy chairs out there.
Wait to go to jail.
Just glad you ain't got the cuffs on.
So when were you on the board, Cindy?
So Cindy, it's
very nice to meet you.
They were here all that time we did this.
No, they didn't.
If they were here, we voted
the one before.
Okay, let's just make a decision. We want in here or not.
Oh, I mean, it doesn't matter to me. I'm just saying.
John, back in here?
I don't care.
It doesn't matter.
It does not matter to me. If anybody else has an issue, one way or the other,
we can go ahead and
do that one. No.
Reporting by balance, it's being paid.
Yeah, how paid
you? Yeah, but you have to hold that balance.
Yeah.
So, do we want him to come back in?
No.
Well,
And that was unanimous.
Unanimous.
Do you want to have them come back in?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, go, come on back in before we come, please.
Wow, that was fast.
Ladies, ladies.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You want us up there or back there?
These are our ballot, ballots, votes, yeah.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations, and thank you very much for coming in and applying.
It was a hard choice.
It was.
Qualified, but overqualified. And this is only till April 2025, right?
Six.
Six.
Twenty-six.
Yeah, it was wrong in that. We're good.
Okay.
Unless you don't want it.
Well, to see how it's going, but yeah, that's good. I thought it, because I know we just had the election, but then in the paper it says 2025, so.
That's right, when your paper.
Yeah, gotta, you know, I love the paper, I read the paper, but they send you a proof, and then you write it back and say, hey, this was wrong, can you change it? And then you read the paper, and it's just like the proof.
Yeah.
It's like a big Ollie, never to quote me.
They do say that.
Yes.
Please, don't do it.
Alrighty, well.
So we have to, the one thing that we have to do is I have to swear you in.
Okay. Okay.
But I need to finish this up first, I don't know when you want to do that.
You tell me.
You can do it then.
I could, I'm meeting Char tomorrow at 9:45.
Yeah, let's do it then.
And before that, like, I want to do, it's just you and me.
You know, it's gonna, just gonna take you like a minute.
Okay.
A minute to win it.
So like if I come at 9:30?
Sure.
Good, tomorrow?
I think so.
Or do you want me to wait? I can wait.
No, go ahead, 9:30 tomorrow night.
Okay.
Yep, that works.
Okay, do we, what about the committee?
We're.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Cindy.
Good luck. Thank you. Hey, can I have your phone number so I can call you for advice?
Yes, you can.
Alright. Alright. Thank you, Cindy.
Okay. Fire and water. Personnel, forestry, NWRP, and ethics.
Okay, I'll make a motion to appoint the District 3 supervisor to the vacant appointees.
Any one question?
Okay.
I'll second that, so we can discuss it.
So the motion's on the floor, so you can open up for discussion. Later, good, we can discuss it now.
Build it already. My only question is, and I'm not, are we going to go any way with this?
Yep.
No pun intended by this either. But a new member on one of the committees, are we okay with that? Because that puts a whole complete, another new member on that committee with one veteran. So my question now, I'm just asking, do we not want to see if we can put a veteran on that committee?
I think if that's the case, then we need to have another committee meeting to where we're doing more than just filling vacancies, because we'll probably want to swap people around. Because if somebody's taking over more and then one's getting less, we'd want somebody to give up something to go to that committee. I think that'd be the only fair way to do it.
I'm just asking.
Yeah, yeah. No, no, no.
We're just.
I see your point. I'm not at all arguing that one. That's a good idea.
My honest opinion, though?
Yep.
If you weren't qualified to be on that committee?
Oh, absolutely.
Absolutely.
It's just throwing somebody in with the
But then you would catch up.
Yeah.
And then go through that.
Yeah.
Just throwing it out, what you guys.
Yeah, the only thing there would be is if we had had it on the agenda to where we looked at for them, because right now the only thing on there is the vacancies. So we couldn't, so we couldn't take somebody off of somebody, something else to put them there, put her over there, that's the problem, but.
Well, we don't have to, we can just appoint two. We don't have to take anybody off of something, we can just appoint them under board.
But then if you get too many, I don't know, you get one person with too many committees. I don't know. I can see it either way, but.
How often does that NWRP?
I think that's quarterly.
Is it, okay, I wasn't sure.
I think, don't quote me, I've only been to a couple of them.
No, I will bring up, to your point, when Dan Kudus got on board, not this time, but the time before, he came midterm that time.
Right.
He preferred to stay on HHS, which he was a citizen appointed member there, but in order to be the county appointed position, he couldn't stay, you know, he. So he would have originally filled in the vacancy in forestry, so that's where he originally got appointed. He said, I don't wanna be on that. I don't, it's not that I don't mind being on that, but I'd rather.
That's how that shuffled you in mind.
Yep, I'd rather be on this. Can you swap? So then we had a separate.
It was a mutual one.
Yeah, it was a committees, and I said, I'm good either way, but I, you know, as long as I'm, for me, I said, the biggest thing is it has to be an afternoon committee. So he was good with it, I was good with it. We came back to committees, and we voted on swapping the two committees to make it, because, and the argument there was, to your point, was that person was appointed to committees based on their strengths. Now, if there's a vacancy and somebody else comes in, they might have strengths in different places.
Right.
But that was a swap committee for committee, though. Did I say too many words?
No, I just thinking through.
There you go.
That's why I'm just throwing out, so what's your turn thought, what's your fight in the corner here? What do you think?
I don't think so.
Were all on these committees, or what about your con?
So I don't think, and I know some are on committees, others are planning, or they can't catch up, they can't keep up, so they're not knowing. And also, not really, but no, somebody to ask us about what was in there.
Like I said, the only one I know from past experience is the swap that we did after that, which was mutually agreed upon, seemed beneficial for both of us.
Right, we're not doing that here.
Yeah.
Are you sleeping?
No. You're so soft, my ears aren't picking it up, my electronic.
Everybody tells me that, I feel like I'm yelling.
I feel like you've gotten better.
Yeah.
Like you, when you're up here, the first couple of times, you're pretty soft, but I think you've got.
Yeah.
Okay, so if I had to break this down, the only concern is this one. We need to put a veteran on that, otherwise I'm good with all the rest.
How would you decide?
Oh, I guess you just kinda, well, you're not gonna trade. I'm not volunteering though.
I think you gotta have five. Odd number.
If I chose somebody, chose me, I'll. You're through that hack already.
No, I'm, yeah, I guess it's another tower.
If I choose, if I choose me, then the hat there. Turn off on that.
I think she filed for the position, she should get the positions. Unless she decides she, like, Dan.
Unless she gets overwhelmed.
That was a unique one, actually, to be honest.
Okay, so if it gets too overwhelming and it's too much, then you can address it.
Yeah, I guess.
Go, try one.
But we interviewed them, I think they're qualified.
Yeah, so I want, against that night, that person.
Tell them that you're thinking, I can't read your mind.
I'm getting $20,000. Hey, it, I wouldn't have a problem swapping, and I do think Mr. Kuda would do an excellent job at the position and he's a veteran. But, hey, I would personally, I'd give up the committee to get another committee. If, and the agenda's not written that way. So that being said, with how the committee, with how this agenda is, I would probably argue to keep the empty committees. And I really do think that, Tom do excellent on that, and maybe that's something that, if interested, you can have Tom talk to her and say, hey, is there one that I'm on that you might, if that's something that interests him, and we could come back. You know, because we did appoint the committees based on people's strengths, not necessarily, you know, she's coming in, she's just getting whatever Stacy's strengths were, right, or whatever he put down for. So she might want one of the other ones. But to keep it fair, I would start with appointing to the vacant ones. That'd be personally, and I can see either side of that really well, so I'm not at all like strongly disagreeing with you. I'm just making what's going on with all of my thoughts.
The only thing is the ethics, you can't, because he has to appoint for that one. That's his job.
Okay, so we can say the ones that we appoint and then that one.
That's, yeah.
I think at the last committees, we made a recommendation to appoint to those committees.
I think we need more veterans on that. Not a newbie, because that's four newbies.
Okay, well, the motion stands on the floor at the moment to go with the existing committees. Is there, shall we have seconded? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say sign. Aye. Opposed.
No.
No, it's a no.
No.
So the motion passed. Did you know what I mean?
Yeah, but you're supposed to say no, because that way there's no doubt. When they say aye, are they going for or against it? You should say, those opposed, say no. I'm very clear.
Okay.
I agree. I second that.
Well, now we're.
All in favor, say aye or no.
Yeah, being like, I made Chris's name up for the personnel committee. Any other nominations for that committee?
I think this needs further work. Land and Water supposedly is gonna meet every other month. Forestry is every month. Ethics hasn't met in years. NRV is, well, I think quarterly, so. Huh?
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure it is.
I don't know.
Nothing good against Tom, but try and get people to cover it.
Well, you can ask Tom.
Tom, are you open to personnel? Or how many committees do you have now? Do you feel overloaded or no, or yes, or what?
I have four. I don't know, do you copy that?
No, not really.
So I have four. I have animal control, JYP, emergency services. Then I only got three. I only got three, actually.
Okay, so I threw your name in the hat. If you wanted, or would you take it if you was voted to it?
The personnel?
Yes.
Yes, I would take it.
Is there any other, no needs for the personnel?
I think you make a motion, not make a nomination.
Right.
Nominations is like the highway commission.
Right.
I thought the only time it'd be.
Ours.
Yeah, so, yeah, that's.
So my motion is to.
Second.
Second, Ms. Good. Any questions, if not? All favors, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same side?
No.
Any more?
I'm aye.
You're aye. On what side of the street?
Well, if the other motion failed.
Well, you didn't answer, so technically you voted for it.
Yeah. My first thought was put that one on, but if they can't be on.
Right.
Second, just to get it done.
Back to the landmark, forestry, and the yard. The three block hour is long. And the motion to sign Kathy to the landmark, forestry, and the yard two.
Yeah, I'll make a motion to appoint her to those three and recommend that the chair appoint her to ethics.
Motion by Mr. Anderson's to appoint landmark, forestry, and the yard two, and recommend I appoint her to ethics. For a second.
I don't know if I can put that in there now. I did.
I'll second.
Second by Ms. Good. All favors, say aye.
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 Opposed?
No.
No?
No. But didn't you guys already send something out on?
No.
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 But you had. I talked to Sheldon. I talked to him down at the WCA, and he knew what was going on, what was going on. So that's fine. I'll reach out to him. That one's not too hard to catch up with. They got a lot of work. Very good.
The office has lots of. Salaries.
Please.
So it'll be on land and water, forestry, and then we have to northwest.
Regional farm.
I have to deploy.
And your chair is right there.
The ethics.
That's fine.
Job two, I don't know when, this is the guy from forestry. You can ask him when we start, or when the next meeting and the date for it was.
Land and Water's got an appointment, or got a, they have a meeting on.
October 19th, at 3 p.m., this is forestry, next forestry committee. In industry.
Land and Water's having one, 6:30 before the county board meeting. You should have posted it in.
Oh, we did, okay, there you go.
Thursday.
Right.
No, Mark, no, so the county board's October 26th.
Some stuff came up, you just gotta get approved, so.
So I'm.
we'll get you up to speed on all of it. It's right before county board, okay, in the meeting.
Kitty Corner from the clerk's office, that's the small copy, that's all I have.
Well, Nick, because Nick is.
And ethics,
I was on for years and,
You should have like an organizational meeting or something on that, just to.
I think that, we should at least call a meeting just to get known the things that are going on at home.
Yeah.
Who's chairman?
Are you, is the chair the chair? I think you might be the chair. Not that, not the sitting chair, I'm talking about.
See, it's just the chair.
I'd have to look it up for sure, but I believe that.
Tom, you have a meeting tomorrow.
Eleven to five.
Eleven.
Is there any other questions you have?
Okay, sir.
I don't know whether to say, well, what do you think, or?
Oh, you're good, you're good.
Very intimidating.
It's intimidating every year.
How many years you got?
It's intimidating every year.
We got a report, no.
Get along, come.
But I'm chairman and he's vice chair. So that's why we throw it.
I mean, we just vote for fun.
Okay, is there anything else? Approval of the minutes, update today. So I need the motion to approve the minutes of today's meeting of October 16th, 2024. Somebody make a motion.
I can make a couple of motions.
We do.
It's not that hard.
By the time you're gonna be out of here, Terry, I'd make that motion. I'll make that motion for you.
Okay, Lois is gonna. Lois made the motion.
I'll second it, so Terry can get going.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign, minutes approved. Terry, is there a motion to adjourn?
You don't need a motion.
No, you don't.
You can do it.
Just say it.
I like to say it, I don't want to say a motion.
He just said motion to adjourn, so we're done.
Yeah.
I got a motion.
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn by Mr. Anderson, is there a second, Terry?
Now there's a motion on the floor, so it's gotta, you know, die or have a second, then it could go on for.
It's good, second, right?
Hey, I've already been through a long meeting.
Trying to get a little, you know, excited on it.
No, I just wanted to be on the minutes so that we know he was here.
Okay, we're all in favor?
Aye. 3:48, huh?
Are you going to pick Kathy up to the office?
Sure.
Say, get her a computer maybe or something like that.
I don't think, she's gotta get a, I mean, she's gotta get a badge. There's quite a few things for you.
If there's stuff we can do today, why do it tomorrow?
It's completely up to you.
I'm fine.
If you have time.
I have time.
Whatever time is present.
There'll always be things forgotten, and so you'll be dragged in here. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kathy.
Thanks, Kathy.